All right, this is fifth grade, module 3, lesson 14, and the purpose of this lesson is to strategize to solve addition problems and subtraction problems. The idea being, sometimes we don't have to follow the official standard algorithm. Sometimes we can use logic to make the problem simpler. Let's do some examples so that you could see what I'm talking about. So it says, rearrange the terms so that you can add or subtract mentally. And then, of course, solve the problem. So the idea being is we're going to look at this first problem, and we're going to see if we can add something together mentally to make our life easy. And I can see a couple of examples. I can see that 1 3/4 plus 1/4, I can add those two together, and I get 2. Similarly, I could see that 1/2 plus 1/2 is 1. So I can add those together and I get 3. And I'm done. I just added that whole problem together mentally without using any standard algorithm, in this case without getting common denominators for all the fractions. Now for our math purists, they're probably going to not like the way I did it. So let's be a little bit more official here. And what we're going to do is we're going to use the commutative property to move the quarters next to each other and to move the halves next to each other. And then we're going to use the associative property to add these together. So 1 3/4 plus 1/4, that's equal to 2. And 1/2 plus 1/2, that's equal to 1. And now we have 2 plus 1, and that equals 3. All right. So that's a little bit more of an official way of doing it. Up here was a little bit informal. That's all right. Similarly, let's do this one. So this says we've got 3 1/6. We're going to subtract 3/4, and we're going to add 5/6. So let's use the commutative property to get the sixths next to each other. Now here's the tricky thing, and then we've got the 3/4 left over there. Now here's the tricky thing. This says start with 3 1/6. This says take away 3/4, so that's over here. And this says add 5/6. So a lot of students are going to want to leave the minus sign and the plus sign stationary and then move just the numbers. No. Actually, what's happening, and I'm going to zoom in so that we can see this a little bit better. What's happening is, here, this says we're going to take away 3/4, and this says we're going to add 5/6. So when we move them around, you need to make sure that the new problem still is adding 5/6 and is still subtracting 3/4. Now that we've done this, we can use the associative property right here. And 3 1/6 plus 5/6, that equals 4, minus 3/4. And now we could do that in our head. And that answer is 3 1/4. All right. And I'm going to zoom back out so that we can see everything we've done so far. There you go. Now let's do the next problem. All right, so for this problem, we're adding 3 numbers that have a sum of 14. But we don't know what this third number is. So one way to do it, the official way maybe, would be to start with 14 and then subtract each of these numbers. But we're going to see if we can do a little bit of logic and a nice little shortcut. So I'm going to write this problem out a little bit spread out here. There. And let's get our common denominator for just these two fractions. And a common denominator is 12 that we can use. We don't have to use 12, but that's a good one. So we're going to change the sixths into twelfths, and we're going to turn the fourths into twelfths. So the denominator, how do you turn the denominator into 12? You do 6 times 2, which means the numerator is going to be multiplied by 2, and that gives us 10. And similarly, how do you turn the denominator of fourths into a denominator of twelfths? You multiply by 3, which means we multiply the numerator by 3. And so we get a numerator of 3. So now I'm going to see that if, well, let's just add these together. So 9 plus 1 is 10. That was this 9 plus this 1 is 10. And then 10 twelfths plus 3 twelfths gives us 13 twelfths plus a blank equals 14. And really, 10 and 13 twelfths, that equals 11 and 1 twelfth plus what? Equals 14. Right. Now here, I would use our nice little empty number line. And our empty number line is, we're going to start with 11 and 1 twelfth, and we need to figure out what we have to add to it, what we have to add to it to get all the way up to 14, because that's what we're doing right here. Well, first thing I'm going to do is figure out what we can do to bump it up to the next whole number, which is 12. Well, that means we have to add 11 twelfths. So that bumps us up to 12, and then 12 plus 2 gives us 14. So we could see our correct answer, our missing value, is 2 and 11 twelfths. 2 and 11 twelfths. And our last problem, I chose this because it's a good opportunity to draw a tape diagram to help us understand what's going on. So it says Laura bought 8 3/10 yards of ribbon. She used 1 2/5 to tie a package and 2 1/3 to make a bow. And Joe later gave her 5 3/5 yards. So how much does she have? So actually, I'm probably not going to draw. I think I might draw a number line on this one. I think a number line might be pretty. So we might start here with 8 3/10, because that's what she started with. And then she used 1 2/5, so that means we're going to go backwards, 1 2/5. And then she used 2 1/3, so we're going to go backwards, 2 1/3. And then Joe gave her 4 3/5, so that means it's going to go forward, 4 3/5. So that's going to help me understand all of this. It's going to help me efficiently write the equation, which is 8 3/10 subtract 1 2/5 subtract 2 1/3 and add 4 3/5. All right, so there we go. So I think what I would do is I would say, well, let's use the commutative property, because I want to put this guy next to this guy. All right, so I'm going to write 8 3/10 plus 4 3/5. Let's do minus 1 2/5, and then minus 2 1/3. So I'm going to scroll up a little bit. So there's our expression, and now let's solve it. Now, first thing I see is, well, let's do, let's subtract here. So we're going to add in 4 3/5, but we're also going to subtract out 1 2/5. So let's just use the associative property right here and do that practically in our head. So 4 minus 1 is 3. 3/5 minus 2/5 is 1/5. So now we have 8 3/10 plus 3 1/5 minus 2 1/3. All right, so now let's get our common denominator. In this case, it's going to be, if we wanted to, we can get a big common denominator for all three of these numbers. Our common denominator could be 30. Let's do that, in fact. So our common denominator is going to be 30. Now, teachers and parents, you may have to pause the video and help the students see why the common denominator is 30. So to turn the denominator of 10 into a denominator of 30, we're going to multiply by 3, which means we're going to multiply our numerator by 3, which is 9. To turn our denominator of 5 into a denominator of 6, we're going to multiply by 6, which means we multiply our numerator by 6. And to turn our denominator of 3 into a denominator of 30, we're going to multiply by 10, which means we're going to multiply our numerator by 10. And now we are free to get going on this. So I'm going to scroll down even further. So let's see. We're going to do, and we could do this all in one step. We could do 8 plus 3 is 11, minus 2 gives us 9. And then let's do the fractions. 9 thirtieths plus 6 thirtieths is 15 thirtieths. And then 15 thirtieths minus 10 thirtieths gives us 5 thirtieths. So technically our answer is 9 and 5 thirtieths, but we want students to be able to see that that could be simplified because both the numerator and the denominator can be divided by 5. So our fraction could be written as 9 and 1 sixth. But really, either of these would have been correct. Whoa, that was a big problem. I don't know if our strategy made that much simpler. That was just a big old problem. And that's grade 5, module 3, lesson 14. The idea being, occasionally we can use strategy to make the problem simpler.